might take some to repeat some thank yous I said to you over the evening. I want to take say sincere thank you to the administration. Our school, they love football. They like soccer, they like volleyball, they like basketball. These guys love football. And we appreciate everything you do for our guys. And I sincerely appreciate everything you guys do for me as a head coach. Next, I want to say thank you again to the boosters. You guys are outstanding. I think Coach Sullivan said it best. We say, hey guys, we need something. They say, order it. They don't ask how much it costs. They don't ask if we can get it cheaper somewhere else. They say, order it. Well, if you want to order the bottom one, then order what you want. Order what you need. And for a middle school to have that, I guess I can feel a little bit of what Gary Fowler feels like over at Clayton High. But we appreciate it, and we thank you for all your support. I suppose I gotta say thank you to the parents. Conditioning drill that we had to run because Coach Kraft found somebody talking out of line. But parents, you guys allowed me to work with some young student athletes, some young men, and I emailed you this, I told you this a lot, but I love that part of my job. I really love teaching, but you know what, I love working with these guys and watching them grow and tell them to tuck in their shirts and tell them to say please and thank you and all that kind of stuff. Means the world to me, and if y'all ever need anything, let me know, because I will talk to you anytime, anywhere, any day. Right. And then finally, I guess I need to say thank you to the cheerleading coach, because she helped you guys win conference. Thank you to the cheerleaders. It would be great if you, you kept all these guys in line, and we do appreciate it. Thank you to the soccer team for coming out and allowing us to use your field on Thursdays. Appreciate that. We got more home games next year, so watch out. And the volleyball team, I'll apologize first. We didn't come to enough volleyball games. Wednesdays and Mondays didn't work out too well with our practice, but towards the end of the season, we got out there a few times. It was fun to watch you guys, and I hope they weren't too distracting, too loud. For y'all to do your thing on the volleyball court. All right. The three guys in front of me, my assistant coaches, are three outstanding assistant coaches that brought three very different sets of talents to the football coaching staff this year. Start with the defensive backs coach, Jermaine Grimes. And our defensive line coach and motivational speaker, Coach Kropp, Brandon Kropp. Chris Hills. Rob says he's going to crop y'all. Somehow, during the course of this year, every once in a while we got to do some extra motivation to reinforce some team principles, some team discipline, too much talking in everybody's class, including mine. And somehow, crop went from a noun to a verb. Because if you got crop, you got to spend extra time on the practice field with this guy. And I don't know what he liked more. I don't know if he liked yelling at the kids more, motivating them more. Come on, man. Or cropping the kids. I'm pretty sure it was cropping the kids. So, you three assistant coaches allowed me to, you know, when I show up on Thursdays, I call the boys. And you guys put in a lot of legwork with these kids. You get to work. outstanding role models for that group of 35 young men. So we appreciate it. Two managers, I believe Cole 2 is here tonight. Come on up, Cole. Evan Harding is not here. He's at a circuit bowl playoff, 7-10 practice, and you know what? Sometimes that's more important. That's okay. But Cole 2, come on down, man. Cole 2 suffered a couple of injuries in practice this year. Yeah, step on. Cole was always involved. He was always eager to help. He was always around. He was always around in practice. You know, we didn't have to wonder where it was. He was always right here. And, you know, that's a good thing. Cole, too, we're looking forward to you coming out next year, being a part of this team, and taller, stronger, faster. Got it. Seventh graders, come down and get number order, starting with 395. My seventh graders, it's a tough spot sometimes. Keep waving that along, Logan. Keep walking around. Seventh graders on this football team is a tough thing because there's this draw of something called 17 and something that they want to keep playing, and it's a tough draw sometimes to get good, talented seventh graders to come out and try for our team because there's two very good youth league programs. They can be the studs on their youth league team. They can come out and work hard for our team, and I appreciate all you guys for coming out. We told you early on, it's tough to break the starting lineup. It's tough to get a couple of plays in here or there. In fact, in our last game of the season, we had 1 7th grader play 2 snaps. That's it. That's because there's a group of 24 8th graders that are pretty good football players, too. But y'all grew as football players, you grew as young men, you grew in the classroom, and we expect huge things out of you next year in terms of leadership, ability, and if it's cool with you, domination. Alright? Okay, number 3, Joseph Collins. Number 7, Josh Collin. Josh was an individual student athlete. Number 17. He's your boy. He's the second best quarterback in the entire county. What that stuff for him. But it's your show next year, man. Number 20, individual student athlete award, Cole Schiefenbein. Number 32, another individual student athlete, Dylan Corbett. Riders. Come on now.
Smith.
Number 56, Drew Schaefer. Number 60 and number 92, Caleb Williams. Number 65, Ethan Parker. It's a rarity to find a two-year starter on our football team because our eighth graders are so good. But Heath was one of just two, maybe three on this football team that started for us last year as a seventh grader and this year as an eighth grader. Heath, you're a heck of a football player, man. I wish I had you back. Number 68, Dylan Hanneman. Number 70, our starting center. I love centers, man. I played center. I love centers. They got the toughest job in the world. Isn't that right, Frankie? Yes. Number 70, Frankie Miller. Some days we called him the calf because he didn't work too hard. Wanted to take a play off. But when push came to shove, he was the bold one he needed to be. Number 72, Brendan Lee. I mean no disrespect by what I'm going to say, because I've coached for 7 years at Riverwood, and two as a head coach, and I've coached about 160 different student athletes. And number 75, Matt Morgan's the best one we've ever had. Number 88, our tight end, Josh Tutt. Adonis Kinsey. All right, before you guys go grab your seats, let's talk a little bit about the season. I'm not going game by game. I can talk about four touchdown days and five touchdown days and giving up 22 points to Princeton, but we're not going to do that. Right. We'll say this much. We beat Princeton. Meadow didn't even want to play you guys. They were too scared. We beat Clayton. We beat Smithfield. We beat Cleveland. We beat McGee's. And y'all took it to Arch Lodge. And by my count, you played seven games and you won all seven. And that right there is perfection. It doesn't matter that you scored 180 some odd points. It doesn't matter that we gave up just about 40 points and that's it. All that matters is you played seven games, you won them all. And that, fellas, is perfection. Outstanding job. Nobody will ever be better than you. You set the bar, and they can only hope to achieve what you guys accomplished. Outstanding job. We miss you guys. Don't worry, I'm not going to cry. But I will miss you guys, and it will be an honor to go watch you guys play in high school at Corinth, at Clayton, and on up from there. So I love you guys. I'm always going to be your football coach, and you come to me whenever you need anything. You understand? All right. Fellas, to you. Fellas, to you. No tears in my eyes.
Hey, first, thank you, parents, for helping out with the boosters. It's been wonderful for all the events we're doing just for your children, the young men, your daughters. So thank you, first of all. But we wanted to present the boosters for the conference champions. We have a new trophy case that will be put up any day now. So we wanted to put something in besides the conference champion trophy. Something for y'all to want to take out.
Go!
very much. It'll be fun to put that as the first trophy going into the new trophy case. We'll bring some of the other sports over too. All right, fellas, you can grab your seats. Morgan's got something to say.
Okay, well, I just wanted to thank you, Coach, because these past 2 years have been the most fun 2 years of my entire life. And it also helps when I'm kind of a championship, too. So I just want to say thank you.
Coaches, I wanted to thank you all for all the times you proud of me. All the times. All the times you make me better. Every time you pop me in my head, you make me better by a lot. Thank you.
Thanks for being the best football coach I've ever had, and you taught me a lot. You've been the best coach I've ever had. Coach Hills, Coach Kyle, you've been the best assistant coaches, and you teach me a lot, so thank you guys.
When you two were in my class. Alex Abercorn, you had a 99.0 average, which is phenomenal, the second best on the football team. Andrew Bond, you had a 99.5, congratulations. And somehow our football players got the Team Scholar Athlete Award. We tied the cheerleaders at a 91.9. That's pretty phenomenal. And I'm pretty proud of those guys because I told them day one they're students first, athletes second. And whatever else we need to take care of, they take care of. I'm proud of you guys. Enjoy 7-0. No one can ever take it away from you.